Today's telecast is being presented live from Los Scandalous Shake and Bake Arena. And, Rich, we've got some major star sightings today.
Oh, look, there's Tom Shanks! And there's Tyler Scarry! And, that's Jennifer Gorence! Wow! Are those things real or fake, you think, Rim?
Well, if you're talking about those two big chihuahuas she's holding,
yep,
they look real to me, Pop.
Today's matchup features the two teams who survived the regular season and playoffs. Tonight, they go to war in the mayhem. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the Full Metal Mayhem. Welcome to Mayhem Bowl Sunday. I'm Owen Grim Blitzro here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and see what the team captains have to say. And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitzro with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Bricks. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of death.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
And it's first and 10. He was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Oh, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go. And it's first and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
Chance for a good return here. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and 10.
Second and three. Second down and a lot. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating for some. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
Third down and nine. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field. First and 10. Right Rage ignites that deep down violent rage and makes you unstoppable.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel, got blown across the room into the deer antlers. You'd think a robot would do the electric slide, wouldn't you, Grim?
It's in their programming to reject that particular move, Bricks. Two on the nose. That and, well, the robot. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And he sinks into the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste sound, but can't remember what the concept of time is.
Sounds like new every day.
Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. Second down and long. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have 1 left. But in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock.
Oh, that was a great throw and a great catch.
Yeah, but it was an interception. Oh, nice hit.
Lunch.
and they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Second down and more than the QB would like. Second time out. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries. Great killer products like Roundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. And we are back here to start the third quarter at a very lopsided Mayhem Bowl, filled with scores mainly by one team. Their fans are beyond drunk at this point. Look at this guy there. He just rejected the idea of pants. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And he just wrestles away from that tackle. And it's first and ten. Second down and six. Third down and nine. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
And a dog being snagged. He had to play a card and die.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Second down in a very long. Oh, what a run there. Touchdown. No one was going to stop him. Yeah. that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called...
It's good! Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Man, what a hit that was! And it's first and ten. With multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the top. But, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and ten.
Team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
And it's first and ten. 2 minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
Grab me a scotch while you're up.
First and ten.
One, two.
The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick. The quarterback can't dump it.
And now they're going to dump his ass. Okay.
And the defense quickly calls a timeout. They want to get the ball back. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Oh, and he just turned ginormous. Look out! That's about a 3-yard pickup. The defense has to make something happen here with one timeout left. Third down, and, well, good luck. Just got smashed.
Not as bad as me last night. He may be dead, but trust me, he's in better shape than I am right now. Oh, geez, here it goes.
He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection, too.
Now that is weird side effect, Bricks. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. Nice and easy, like defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And here comes the extra point attempt.
As expected, those are pretty much
game since they can't rest their players. And the defense calls a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Now this takes me back to his break. He punched his way out of that tackle. Second down, and that'll be their final timeout. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. Not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and one. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Oh, with the brain scrambler. This game didn't live up to the hype and was a total blowout. These guys threw a first-round knockout punch before halftime.
Yeah, and I drank my first Hawaiian Punch knockout drink before halftime. Rum and punch, nothing better, Grim.
Well, let's hear what the Mayhem Bowl's MVP has to say. Once again, the folks at Evil Sam thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. And that's a wrap. All right, that's another season, boy. Good job. Hey, Bricks, the cheerleader's in, huh? Hey, Junior, start rolling.
On it, boss.
I love you guys. We got the best gig in the world.
Hey, stow it, dipshit. Start filling the hot tub. Hey, where's the champagne?
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard.